Thank you for watching. Today we are looking at, this is not a diecast vehicle, today we're looking at the FMS Suzuki Jimny. And this has been sent to me by a company called Fury RC, and I will make sure that there is a link to their website in the video description box. Fury RC has a wide variety of RC products, and this FMS Suzuki Jimny is definitely one that caught my eye just because it is so exceptionally detailed. I know there's a couple of videos on these out already. I have not bothered looking at those just because I want to have my own eyes and my own opinion about this vehicle and then pass that on to you. I have been really taken by surprise by how incredibly detailed this thing is, but also by the amount of features that it packs. This is, like I said, an officially licensed Suzuki product, so you can also see that on this suitcase, because it doesn't come in a box. This comes in an exceptionally nice polystyrene, polyfoam type of enclosure, because it even comes with, like, there's a handle on it, there's a lock on this thing. So this, if you want to transport it around, if you want to haul this thing around to use it somewhere else than at home, then this really safely packs it up and make sure that you don't damage it during transport. There's a sleeve that sits around this suitcase, and this also shows some of the features. Again, not all of them for some reason. So I really think that they've kind of done themselves a disservice by not listing all of the features on this sleeve. It says some of the key features, like, for example, that it has metal gears, that it has, like, a detailed interior, but it does not mention anything about a two-speed, which is included, and that just strikes me as pretty strange. There is a manual, although this is not the most elaborate manual, just put it like that. So there's an English section, then there is a Chinese section, and then in the back you will find some exploded views and also some parts numbers in case you want to order some spares. I think that we do need to address that they are talking about a different type of radio in the manual than what you actually get with, because if you look at these four dip switches over here, that is not something that they go into in the manual at all. Let's get that out of the way immediately. These four dip switches, one of them is for a crawler reverse, the second one is for LiPo or nickel metal hydride, and the third and fourth one are so you can cycle through no drag brake at all, 25%, 50%, 75%, or 100% drag brake. So all of that stuff, you can set that up from your radio, which I think is pretty cool. This radio, it is really small. I got exceptionally large hands, but it really feels like it is child-sized to me once I hold this. It takes four AAA batteries. That as well, it's a tiny bit of a confusion inside the manual if it's AA or AAA batteries. It is AAA batteries, and it functions pretty well. It doesn't have, like, a ton of range, but you don't need that either. Your reverse switches are on top over trim switches below that, and then there's a third and even a fourth channel. Now, if we look at the car itself, this RC car, because this is not like an RC truck, this is also something you don't want to compare this to any type of other 10 scale RC trail truck, because that is really not what it's for. This is kind of die-cast gone RC, so it is so exceptionally detailed and it looks so incredibly nice that you really want to keep this on the shelf. But then the fact that it also moves, so the fact that it also RCs, is just kind of like the cherry on top. The Suzuki Jimny is probably worldwide one of the most affordable off-road vehicles that money can buy, but not in Norway. You would perhaps be surprised to know that this vehicle in Norway, first of all, you can't get it, but if you can get it, they charge you an arm and a leg for it, just because it's so incredibly high on pollution tax and that type of stuff. So if you were to be able to find a Suzuki Jimny in Norway, one of this particular year, then you would pay a whopping $54,000 for one. When I travel through Europe, I see plenty of them, but not over here in Norway. In Norway, this is almost as rare as, for example, a Lamborghini or a Ferrari. I mean, if you're kind of shopping in those price classes, you know that they're going to charge you an arm and a leg. But for a Suzuki Jimny, I mean, come on, nobody wants to pay $54,000 for one. Let's have a quick look at the chassis first. There you will also see that it is completely true to the one-on-one version, so it is exceptionally scaled. That also explains why this is not a performance vehicle. This is also why this is not an RC trail truck that you want to take out with your buddies who have an Axial SCX10 version 3 or a Traxxas TRX 4. That is definitely not what this is intended for. This is intended to be a completely true to scale replica of a Suzuki Jimny, and that it does exceptionally well. So it has a separated suspension, so it has a loose coil and then a loose shock absorber. If you want to take this out in the rough terrain, you won't get very far. But if you have like a diorama type of off-road setup that is indoors, which is also something that I plan on making this winter, this will look right at home. It has steel frame rails. It also has some metal panhard links and steering links, and apart from that, most of what you see underneath here is plastic. So there is a lot of detail going on. You see, for example, there is a full exhaust system that is sort of like indicated. Also metal are these drive shafts, both front and in the back, and also the coupler that goes between the transmission up front and then the transfer case in the center. All of that stuff is metal. So that is pretty cool, actually. You will also see that these are officially licensed Dunlop tires with a foam insert on a really scale looking Suzuki 5-spoke, or actually it is a split 5-spoke, so 10-spoke rims that again look incredibly true to scale. This chassis is set up in a way that is completely true to its full-sized counterpart. So you have the motor sitting up front with all metal gears, by the way. It is a brushed 180 sized motor, and it also has a 2-speed transmission, which is crazy to me. That one is operated by a micro servo. The same with the steering is also operated by a micro servo, and you will also find that if you do steer this vehicle, that the steering wheel on the inside moves along with. So what it lacks perhaps in trail performance, it kind of makes up for in how detailed it is. The use of that lime green, lime yellow color, which is a true color for a Suzuki Jimny, just really makes it pop. If you look at the back, there's a windshield wiper. There's also some sort of indication of window heating, or however you say that. Do keep in mind I'm not a native English speaker. And there's also some electroplated Suzuki and Jimny logos on the tailgate. If you touch these two hinges, you will find that these are also metal. If you look at that grille behind that Suzuki logo in chrome, there's some really nice honeycomb grille going on. And it also goes for the front bumper. Now, they say on the box that you can take the bumper and the fender flares and the roof off to customize that to your own taste. I will not be doing that, just because I think that it looks fantastic the way that it is currently set up. This antenna thingy on the top, this is rubberized, so this won't break off if you are to roll the truck. And the wing mirrors, they fold in, and also have a piece of actual mirror glass on the inside. Now, you will see that I already popped the hood. I also popped the front doors and the back door. I completely shunted this door handle in attempting to open it up the first time. So I put my fingernail under it, and this went flying through the studio. And I was able to find it, thankfully, but it just gives you a bit of an idea, perhaps, on how fragile this model is. If you open up the back, you will see that there are two rear seats that fold down. And there is also a little hatch which opens up, which gives you access to some more storage room. On the front as well, on the inside, you will see that there's door cards. You will also see that there's some sort of indication of upholstery on those front seats, and a really nicely detailed dashboard with, well, like I said, a functioning steering wheel. So the steering wheel moves along with you steering the vehicle. Apart from that, you can also slide the front seats forward and backward, just like you would be able to do in the full-sized version. And also the backrest of those front seats, it folds forward. So it just looks really nice and really well detailed. There's a rear view mirror as well that you can see if you look up inside of that interior. And if my windows look a bit weird, I will make sure that in the close-ups they look good, but I still have the protective film on to keep them from getting scratched. If you open the hood, you will see that there's room for a battery. So there's a battery it comes supplied with. This is a LiPo battery. It is really small, just like the rest of the car, 380 milliamps, but it does the trick. There is also a USB charger, a little thing that you can just plug into a wall socket if you have USB wall sockets, and it will charge that battery up pretty fast. It will give you about 20 or 30 minutes of runtime, and it is tucked away nicely underneath what is a sort of like an air box in front. If you have it plugged in, there's a tiny on-off switch over here, and the lights will come on briefly just to indicate that it is actually on. Let's go ahead and turn it on so you can see what it does. Now, once you have the vehicle turned on, you will see that the steering servo is actually pretty responsive. This is a chassis mounted servo, so it looks incredibly well. So this all works the way that you would want or hope it to work. It's currently in high gear, which makes it really nippy on the throttle. And if you put it in a low gear, it actually really slows it down. Like I said, you can engage crawler reverse by putting that first dip switch upward. And if you don't, then you have on engaging the reverse, you will have the rear brake lights coming on. If you were to put a 1/12 scale figure inside of it, it is really hard to see that this is not a full-sized vehicle if you film this out on a place that really does it justice. Last thing we need to discuss is this fourth channel. You will find that sits over here, so it sits below that third channel toggle switch. And what it does is it cycles you through all of the light modes. So that will give you, I think, some more appreciation even of what they did over here. I'm still really bad at muting myself. In lighting this truck up. So you can see both in the front and in the back, there's an incredible amount of detail going on in the lighting department as well. So you have five different modes that you can switch through. One of them being like everything is off, even I think for steering, yes. And then you have low beam, then you have high beam. I hope the camera picks that up. Then you have the fog lights coming on as well. You can also see that in those front fenders, there's an indicator light. And then in the back as well, there is a fog light. And then you have just fog lights in the front, along with the indicator lights working. I do think that this kind of inspires me to go make some sort of diorama, some sort of indoor course over here. I also know that I have a couple more FMS vehicles on the way. All of them 18th scale. This is a 12th scale vehicle, but seeing that it is so incredibly compact, I do think that it will look right at home on a diorama type of a course. Really fun. Again, go have a look at the link in the video description box that goes to the Fury RC website. I will be taking a look at some more of these FMS vehicles just because I can really see this taking off and kind of putting a different spin on some of the indoor activities that I can do with the hobby over the next coming months if the temperatures outside are just too low to be comfortable and be outside to do some filming. And don't expect this to be a competitive vehicle if you are used to, for example, a Traxxas TRX4 or an Element Enduro. This is a totally different type of RC car. You can already tell that with the bounciness of the suspension, for example. But if you're looking to have a really cool 1/12 scale replica of a Suzuki Jimny, this is definitely the truck for you. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, let me know by pushing the like button. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section and we'll try to get back to you. And if you have not subscribed yet, please do. I will see you in the next video. Take care, bye-bye. Back on.